afternoon, and thank you for having us here in Las Vegas once again. My name is Brennan Longo. My team and I are here to represent the architecture track for Shadow Ridge High School. I am the project manager, site plan specialist, and detail specialist for this project.
Hello, my name is Dylan Patti. I'm the construction schedule manager, as well as the housing finance specialist.
Hello, my name is Jordan Johansson, and I'm the working drawing specialist, as well as presentation, brochure, and notes specialist.
We also have an additional teammate named Vincent Jacobo that was our 3D specialist, but he was not able to come due to his prior school commitments. Today, we would like to show you what we were capable of designing in the time frame provided from concert home sketches that the National Association of Home Builders has provided us. We took into consideration all applicable building codes and revisions needed to make these drawings correct. We present to you our final product and what we believe to be is the quality and the success that the St. Louis building tradition, Concert Homes, has and continues to achieve. This project is located at 802 Caspian Drive in Winsfield, Missouri, on lot 144C of the Carlton Glen community. This family-oriented community offers many amenities, including ponds, pools, parks, and a community center at the beginning. This family-oriented community is perfect for first-time homebuyers or those looking to move up in the housing community.
The Kensaw model has a total livable square footage of 2,318 square feet, with three bedrooms including the master. The master has a full bath and walk-in closet. The upstairs features a Jack and Jill bathroom with two bedrooms and a bonus room. We would like to present you a 3D walkthrough of the Kensaw model, which was produced by our colleague, Vincent Jacobo. The exterior features a mix between horizontal vinyl siding and cedar shake siding. As we walk into the entry onto the main hallway, we pass the half bath onto the kitchen. The kitchen has a white oak cabinets, laminated countertops, and a great work triangle between the sink, stove, and fridge. Passing the dining room, we go onto the great room. Onto the master. The master has a walk-in closet to the right and a bathroom to the left. Going down the main hallway, as you can see a glimpse of the half bath as we go upstairs. Passing the bonus room, we walk into the first bedroom located upstairs. Walking into the Jack and Jill bathroom, on both ends we have a walk-in closet. Entering the second bedroom, located on the second floor. To conclude the walkthrough, we enter the bonus room, which is a great place to lounge. And that will conclude our 3D walkthrough.
In Missouri, there is a yearly low temperature of 19 degrees Fahrenheit and a high of 88, the coldest month being January and the hottest being July. There is a yearly average of 43 inches of rainfall year-round, May having the most. On top of that, there is a yearly average of 13 inches of snowfall from the months December to March, January having the most. The housing weather requirements need to withstand 115 mile per hour winds and up to a 30 inch frost line depth. On top of that, the houses need to be built into a Category C seismic design, a hazardous non-structural damage. The average build time for a house in this area is 7.7 months. Although that is the average, we believe we can get it done much faster. We estimate that the construction start date will begin February 3rd, 2020, taking into account that the original start date was February 1st, a Saturday, therefore we moved it to the closest appropriate workday. We estimate that this will take 94 working days, or 130 total calendar days, coming up as 4.5 months. The permit requirement will start January 6th, 2020, as to allow a month prior to the planned construction start date. This estimation will take 114 working days, or 158 total calendar days, which translates to 5.5 months. This estimation, however, does not include the 31-day adjustment period for weather interruptions, delivery delays, and or damaged or destroyed properties.
With a sale price of $345,857 and a construction cost of $282,144.37, we can achieve a profit of 19% or more exactly, $63,712.63. We'd like to take this time to thank our sponsors, Concert Homes for providing the home, the Northern Arizona Building Association, the National Association of Home Builders for letting us come here and present to you today, our designware, which is Soft Plan, and of course you, the judges, for taking the time out of your schedules to come and judge us. Thank you. We will now be taking any questions or comments you may have.
Great job, you guys. Presentation, everything. Your dedication and to professionalism is very important, and it's very much appreciated. Your attention to detail also is very, very important. Overall, I think that working drawings look fantastic. I would have to say that you put a tremendous amount of detail and notes on it, and that's greatly appreciated. Your floor plans are beautiful, and particularly because you have so much information on here, I loved how you did your notes with the number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and all of those, because it doesn't clutter up the plan. The only thing is, some of those numbers at half scale and this, I can't read, you know, maybe just my eyes, but you could have bumped up the size of those numbers a little bit better. Because what it does is then I can truly, truly appreciate it. I don't have to pull out a magnifying glass to see it. But the way that you did your approach to declutter and use those notations gave a lot more detail to the set of drawings, and it's highly, highly commended. So therefore, when you go and you compare it to the materials and you try to coordinate with the materials at estimate and then also the scheduling, they have enough information and you can build off of this. I had just two quick questions. Oh, and by the way, I love the marketing. I love your job descriptions, although I believe, did somebody call them? No, that was not this one. Who did the basement plan?
It was me.
Okay. May I say that, and your egress window, I think this is the only one that I've seen, even in the associates, I think maybe not. You have the egress window in the perfect location. It's behind the garage. You want to put it, you require an egress for a bedroom situation and a future bedroom. And so I just wanted to commend you on that's the best location for that if you're going to do future options. And then who did the first floor and the location of the HVAC and hot water? Okay. Can you tell me why you located it in the garage? And from the climate description, is that really the best place to put it?
No.
In retrospect, where would you have put it?
Utilities.
Okay. And where in the home would you put it, you think?
In the utility room.
Okay, and where's the utility room?
The utility room is on the, so as we walk in, there was a hallway to the left right away in the second door.
Okay, so it was like where the laundry,
yes.
Where the laundry is? Okay. Or another solution, and that's kind of a remote location. Actually, a great location would have actually been centrally located in on the other side of the stair, but in probably in the basement.
All right.
And, but then there was also a sump, there's a sump pump, right, and a sump pit, and that would want to be located on the perimeter so that that could tie into the perimeter drain. But overall, great job, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Let's see, who am I going to pick on? Jordan. I'll pick on Jordan for a little bit. You showed the electrical panel in the garage. Why didn't you want it there?
Well, that seemed like a really good location since where my house is and other houses in our area, that's where usually they are located.
Yeah. Okay. Normally, like in my area, they charge me, they give me the first 15 feet free, it's in the garage. But for me, I'm going to pay the $3.75 a loony foot more. I'm going to push it back into the unfinished basement. So later on, when I need to finish the basement, I can run wires freely because when I get them in the garage, the garage is drywall. So, but you're absolutely right. But like for me, I'm gonna pay the preferred location for doing that. So, but you were right. I just wanted to find out what your thoughts were on it. You showed two air conditioners on the house.
Yes. So, since I thought that air conditioners needed on the first floor and second floor, just because of the square footage being 2,000.
Okay. So, with two air conditioners, do I do it off of one furnace, or I have to go two furnaces?
One furnace, I believe.
Okay, I think one. Okay. The stairs, I'm still picking on you, I'm sorry. I'm going to get the other guys next. On your stair section, now, I got clients, the one I'm designing right now, he wants a low pitch staircase. You have a low pitch staircase, and I went through those, and your stairs were labeled at 6-inch risers.
Yes.
Okay, can I shrink my staircase in and give it more headroom by getting the stairs a little bit steeper?
Yes, I believe so.
Okay. Yeah, if I cranked it to 14 risers, I'm still at 7.5. I'm within code reason. So 6 inch is kind of, it's a slow slope, but if I watch my head on the ceiling, I might just crunch it a little bit more. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just that a lot of people like slower, less steep stairs. Now I get to pick on, is it Dalen?
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, we got a lot with you. In the estimate, now I do love the estimate because you gave me category totals. I love it. You followed the stuff. I was able to follow it really easy. On that, you had 2x10 floor joists, a lot of them. I don't know where the 2x10 floor joists are. And then you had TGI floor joists, but you labeled them 2x12. Okay. So I needed to go, well, what is the clarification on that? Because I give this to lumber yard, and guess what I'm going to get on the job sites?
2x10. 2x12.
Okay. So when you're picking out your I-joist, it'll be, if it's 11 7/8, you'll go 11 7/8. You did TGI, which is a brand name, so 11 7/8 TGI, but the next phrase would be what series they are, because they come in real skinny, the 210s, 230s. They go up to 560. And the way you have it drawn, the 560 works perfect. That's what I would have chose on it. So just finish your story on it. Just continue the story, finish it off. Drywall, who did the schedule?
The schedule was done by myself and then a little bit of help.
Let's pick out somebody else. Okay. Just watch your schedule. Now, what's going to happen is, Jordan, you might have to go over their schedule as a fresh pair of eyes just to check on them. Plumbing, 412, it was 514 was the plumbing finish up, and the dishwasher arrives 519. Who hooks it up?
Okay. Yeah.
Does the service guy from the company hook it up, or does the plumber usually hook it up?
Well, as planned, we were going to have contractors on site because we weren't sure on how exactly Concert Homes.
Okay. Yeah, you had plumber finish up 514, 515, dishwasher rise 519.
Right.
So he's gone out of the way. Drywall ceiling, 420. Your attic insulation was 4.6 and 4.9. Their specs called out blown-in insulation. So can I blow in insulation in the attic yet?
No.
No. It's good to get it early because in this climate, you did a great job on your temperature map. I did the same thing. I want to know what the temperature. As soon as I hang that lid after insulated walls, I hang the lid, I need to get that drywall warm. So as soon as it's hung, they'll still might be doing drywall on the walls. I'm going to blow the lid.
Okay.
And then when they come to start taping, I got the heat in the house, the mud sticks to my drywall.
Okay.
Good.
All right. 3 minutes.
All right. Overall, very good drawings. I think this was one of the first ones I graded because I got a lot more lines than some of the other ones. So just take them as comments. Like I said, not everything's necessarily points off. Your virtual rendering, did you guys do that together or?
That was produced by our colleague, Vincent Jacobo. So what we did is I designed the whole house and then he took my rendering pretty much of everything and designed, like edited it and.
Okay, it was very cool, very good. Just make sure it matches. I did notice a couple things. You're showing a door between the casual dining and great room I didn't see in there. And then upstairs, bedroom 3 and bedroom 2, there's open walkways to the bathrooms, but those were showing doors. So
yes.
If you're going to do something very cool, just make sure it's accurate. Okay?
Will do.
Double check windows. We had 3060s in the back, so those are going to be too close to the floor. I'm going to have to put basically fall arresters on, and I'm only going to be able to open them up 4 inches. So double check that. Egress
window.
Amy's egress window, I do like the location. Double check the size to make sure it does meet egress. 5.7 square feet for egress. I don't know if that one met. Your floor joists, double check your estimate. It looked like on your plan you're running side to side, correct, with your floor joists?
Yes.
On your estimate you have a 56 foot floor joist. So one, I don't know if they can get them there on a tractor trailer because they're extremely long. Two, if they don't cut out right, then you're going to be wasting a lot of material. So just double check that. Schedule wise, just a couple things out of order. We're showing installing trusses, but I'm still framing second floor walls. Like I said, Dean's coming on the blown-in insulation. I've got a span here from 410 to 420 where I'm doing some exterior work, but I did not find anything being done interior. Always make sure continuously you're getting the inside of the house done. The outside can fall here and fall there, but always make sure that your inside is moving forward.
And with the floor joist or the ceiling joist and roof joist compared to that, we planned if they can get it done early in the morning, like if the contractors or the builders get there 8 a.m. and they finish 12, you still have 6 hours left to work. So
okay.
Some of those things do overlap, but we plan some people finish earlier because they had early in the week, so they have less to get done.
Just be careful with that. If it's the same trade, you're fine. If it's multiple trades or different trades, you're going to overlap, and then it's going to cause headaches.
Yeah.
If it's the framers, I wouldn't even put in install trusses. I would just leave that out. And then I would say deliver trusses, but I would leave that up to the carpenters to install when they feel fit in the process, and then make sure your shingle delivery and your roofing fall in after that. So,
okay.
But if you do have multiple trades, trying to do half days and this and that, it's always a headache.
Okay.
And I gave Miles, so I'll give Miles a minute.
No worries. So great job, guys. I like the way you guys presented with confidence. Each one of you guys came up and talked very very strongly about your subject and what you guys did on the project. I like the way that you guys started off the plan set really strong with your site plan, showing how you're draining the lot to your swale in the rear. I think that was awesome. You guys have a really, really good plan set. I like the way that you guys included an electrical plan and a mechanical plan. Your mechanical plan doesn't have a legend on it, though, like your electrical plan does. So guys might want to include a legend on your mechanical plan that shows what your icons are, how you labeled them. I saw that you guys split the system, so you guys did the second floor from the attic, on the second floor with your AC unit, and then the first floor with the attic access, from the attic access in the garage. So that was a nice touch. On your elevations, make sure your east and west elevation, make sure you guys include the basement. You guys have a basement plan and you show that your egress window, but you don't show it on your elevation. So just make sure your plans are talking to each other. Grid estimate in your schedule. I saw that you guys installed your stairs kind of as you went up each floor. But just be aware of that, because I saw you guys have oak treads and oak risers. Just be aware of that from a weather standpoint of not having your roof on, but having your stairs in, and ultimately that causing damage to your stairs. So I would suggest probably putting it in after you have the roof on. But I think you guys did an awesome job completing the puzzle on this one. I think you did great.
Thank you.
I got a comment. Who figured out how to fold that site and that schedule?
Dean, that was exactly what I was going to ask.
Oh, that is awesome.
Thank you.
I could read it, and I go, who folded this? I'm Polish. I couldn't have figured this out.
We took Amy's comment from last year and did exactly what she said. If you could do it 6 feet long, we did it 6 feet long.
It was beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Absolutely beautiful. Thank you.
Awesome job, fellas.
Thank you.
Thank you.